You have to work.
No, I don't.
I'm going to take the night off. I already arranged it.
I don't believe it.
It's true. Now, what do you want to do? I take you any place you want to go.
I want to have a quiet little dinner at home. Just the two of us.
Okay, sweetheart. If that's what you want to do, that's just what we'll do.
The time has come.
Hey!
Oh, no, you don't.
Well.
Lucy, explain.
I Love Lucy 50th Anniversary Special with guests Cher, Richard Crenna, Andy Garcia, Whoopi Goldberg, Larry King, Jorge Moreno, Leah Remini, Paul Rodriguez, Roseanne, Arturo Sandoval, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Lily Tomlin, Dick Van Dyke, Bruce Valanche, Barbara Walters, Henry Winkler, and Lucy Arnaz and Desi Arnaz Jr.
The Lucille Ball, Desi Arnaz Show, I Love Lucy.
I Love Lucy, Screenwriters Guild submission number 48522. This is an idea for a radio and or television program incorporating characters named Lucy and Ricky Ricardo. He is a Latin American orchestra leader and singer. She is his wife. They're happily married and in love. The only bone of contention between them is her desire to get into show business and his equally strong desire to keep her out of it. From these words submitted by writer-producer Jess Oppenheimer, with an entry fee of $1, came the most popular television show of all time, I Love Lucy. 50 years ago, televisions across America lit up. People gathered around and they saw this. 623 East 68th Street, New York City, the home of Lucy and Ricky Ricardo. And 30 minutes later, I Love Lucy had its first chapter in TV's history books. Now, since its premiere on October 15, 1951, billions of people have watched I Love Lucy. And as we celebrate the 50th anniversary, there is somebody, somewhere, right now, watching an episode. I Love Lucy was the first situation comedy to film before a live studio audience. So picture this. The audience gathers up here in the bleachers, and there's a warm-up act who would come out and tell some jokes, introduce the stars. We found some footage of I Love Lucy's warm-up act that nobody's ever seen. His name?
Mr. Desi Arnaz.
Thank you, Roy. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. We welcome you to Desi Lu Playhouse. I'd like you to meet our landlady in the show. She plays Ethel Mertz, Miss Vivian Vance, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, down. And the fellow that plays our landlord, he plays Fred Mertz, is married to Vivian in the show, that is. Mr. William Frawley, Bill Frawley, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, old man. Thank you very much. And now the other girl in the show, my favorite redhead, my favorite wife, the vice president of Desi Lu Productions Incorporated. I am the president. The mother of my children, ladies and gentlemen. She plays Lucy. Lucille Ball.
The very first episode of I Love Lucy actually premiered after all the others. There was a pilot episode to introduce I Love Lucy to CBS executives and advertisers, but it never aired.
No, not that apart. Yes, that's right.
And then it was missing for over 40 years. Luckily, one of the original kinescopes was discovered, and the lost episode aired for the first time in 1990. The very first footage of Lucy and Desi as Lucy and Ricky.
All right, everybody ready? We go with the professor on the downbeat. Anytime you're ready, professor, we go with you.
Okay.
So CBS said fabulous, and I Love Lucy ran as 179 half-hour episodes, and then the same characters starred in 13 shows called the Lucy Desi Comedy Hour. 10 years of TV comedy perfection. Can you imagine trying to pick the best one? Okay, call me crazy, but tonight, that's just what we're gonna try to do. The show's original creators and other Lucy historians narrowed the list down to 12 classic shows. That was the hard part. Now, these 12 were available to millions from around the world who logged on to CBS.com to select their favorite. Well, the voting has ended, and we're about to reveal number 10 and laugh our way to number 1.
Are you all right?
Oh, I never was so glad to hear anybody speak English in my life, even you.
What happened?
I don't know. Nobody speaks English. They're all foreigners.
The sergeant only speaks French. See, and now this other cop here, he speaks French and German.
Huh?
And this fellow, he speaks German and Spanish.
Oh.
So, he's going to ask the questions and we'll translate them to you.
Oh, good.
Where do
you get the money?
I got it from a man on the street, but I didn't know it was counterfeit.
Lo me lo dio un hombre en la calle, pero yo no sabía que era falso.
Eine Mann in der Straße gibt es mir, weil ich kenne nicht, was es das Geld.
Je l'ai reçu d'un homme dans la rue et je n'ai pas su que c'est faux. Ha!
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 Ich bin unschuldig.
Je suis innocent.
Bien. Si elle rend l'argent, elle peut s'en aller.
Gut. Wenn Sie Ihre Restaurantrechnung bezahlt, kann sie gehen.
Bueno, si ella le paga de vuelta al restaurant, ella se puede ir.
Good. If you pay the restaurant bill, you can go.
Hooray!
Olé!
Well done, well.
Coming up. Four of the best and funniest friends of all time. The I Love Lucy 50th Anniversary Special is sponsored by Olay. Love the skin you're in.
I Love Lucy ended this incredible run just a year before I made my entrance on the Dick Van Dyke Show. And across the decades of classic TV comedies, I Love Lucy set the standard. And for me personally, of course, what an act to follow. Lucy, Ricky, Fred and Ethel. Fred and Ethel are the neighbors, of course, played by William Frawley and Vivian Vance, who both had long careers in vaudeville and radio, Broadway, the movies, but will forever be remembered as the Mertzes to Lucy and Ricky's Ricardos. Inseparable now for 50 years, the Ricardos and the Mertzes are the best of friends. They walk into each other's apartments without knocking, they play a mean game of bridge, and like all friends, they have terrific fights. Usually that means the men divided against the women or vice versa. But no matter what the crisis or what crazy scheme that Lucy got him into, we know that by the end of the show, they'll always be there for each other.
California, here I come. Right back where I started from.
Those were four people who came together in time with just the exact and perfect piece of material for them.
You gorgeous, exciting woman, you.
I pass.
It's fun to watch the two of them who are so much in love and to watch the two old crusty white people, Fred and Ethel, I kept waiting for them to break into song. Because I figure the only time they're really happy with each other is when they're hoofing.
Every sitcom tries to have a Fred Mertz, that incorrigible guy next door. It's complaining and everything. Nothing's going right in there. Marriage stinks.
You know how I get on water. I'll be hungry and thirsty and cranky.
Well, what's your excuse on dry land?
He was the perfect curmudgeon. He had the look, he had the sound, he had the feel.
It's been years since we sat in a movie with your arm around my waist.
It's been years since my arm reached around your waist.
Ethel May is very big here in Albuquerque.
She's big everywhere.
I used to look at him and think he sees in Ricky the dashing young guy that he was. Had he had the chance, he would have gotten Lucy McGillicuddy. Instead, he got Ethel.
Hi, honey bunch.
Oh, shut up.
Vivian Vance was the greatest straight woman. She was unbelievable and funny in her own right.
She said my mother looks like a weasel.
Apologize, Ethel. No.
Oh, come on, Ethel. Tell him you're sorry.
Well, I'm sorry your mother looks like a weasel.
I like how she had those great husband put down jokes.
If some woman was trying to take Fred away from you, you'd sing another tune. Yeah, happy days are here again.
When we were thinking of the characters, we needed a pal for Lucy, and we wanted a woman who could play comedy.
You rang, Mom. Ethel May, you seem to have forgotten the gravy. Oh, I'm sorry, Mom, but you know how forgetful us old nannies are. That will be all, Ethel May. You bet your sweet life.
You want to get downtown and have dinner with the boys?
Yes. What boys?
Lucy, I'm home.
Ricky was sexy, and he was like a safe guy that you could feel sexy towards. I mean, that's a hot piece of Desi Arnaz right there.
The ladies look at me and sigh. In my arms, they want to die. You're mine. Mine. All mine. They go wild, simply wild over me.
Desi was like Lucy's father in a lot of ways, you know.
Guess who the teller said was overdrawn, Lucy?
Aren't these delicious-looking pastries? They're real gooey.
I'll give you a hint. He says it's someone who shares my joint account, but it's not me.
When Lucy did something dumb, you knew the minute that Desi walked into the room, you knew what his reaction was going to be.
When I came to America, every time I got really angry, there were certain things you always ended up doing in your own native language.
Ay, qué barbaridad, mira que no saben lo que pasa.
We actually waited for those moments when he lost his cool, when he became Latino.
Ay, qué barbaridad, porque tiene la cabeza más dura de ninguna mujer que yo he conocido en toda la vida entera. Sí, inglés, lo hablo muy bien, muy perfectamente. Usted no me tiene que decir con rebolico ese que no lo hablo bien. Mira que tiene el coraje de decirle a uno ahora que no quiere comprar la máquina de lavar.
Yeah!
We've met a lot of people who said when they first came to this country, they learned their English by watching our show. And boy, great English teacher he was.
I won Swiss apartments. Did you understand what I said? All right. What did I say?
You won Swiss apartments.
And I could explain if I could get in a word chinechwise.
Yeah, just let him get a word chinechwise and he'll explain.
She got somebody telling me that you were seeing a lot of each other, so that I would come up here because I was jealous.
jealous?
Sí, celoso. Oh,
yellows.
Yellows. I understand that a hot dog vendor costs the whole thing.
Pardon?
A hot dog vendor costs the whole thing.
You're trying to tell me something.
They're also damn perfect, but I don't think there's ever been anybody as classically, physically funny as Lucy.
I took the wheel.
Lucy was a housewife who was constantly trying to get in the show business, and Ricky, you're constantly trying to steer her away from that.
Well, I'm going to do a television show, that's all. And you cannot be on it.
Oh, Ricky.
She was gorgeous and she was funny. And how often does that happen?
Made the greatest faces.
Oh.
She had the greatest timing. She had this kind of childlike spirit that came out of her.
You know how she would suddenly cry that, yeah, she would start that cry, and it was hilarious. It just, and I used to say, oh God, if I could only cry like Lucy.
And then she had the one where she was like squelching it, where she'd go like, ooh.
She could be the broadest comedian in the world.
Why don't you cut it out and be yourself, huh?
I'd be very happy to be myself if I could remember who I am. Who am I?
At the same time, she could be so subtle and so small and so tiny, then make it work.
No matter what she attempted, you know, even if she's crawling on the floor, like trying to get behind, you know, hide behind something, or there's just innately, incredibly, brilliantly comedic. Anyway, that's Lucy.
They were, the four of them, so part of Americana, weren't they? We knew them.
Oh, gee, Ethel, thanks. It's times like this when you know what friends are for.
If I'd known this is what friends are for, I'd have signed up as an enemy.
If you're ever in a jam, here I am. If you're ever in the mess, F-O-N.
Truce. Truce.
If you ever.
Ever had.
That's for sure.
Oh, Ricky, they're so... Oh, I could just cry.
If they ever look like your eye, oh, put me wide.
Oh, honey, let's not fight.
If they ever cook you turn needle.
Come on, I'm gonna paste you one, kiddo.
If you ever, I want to know when you're out to die, borrow mine. It's friendship.
Had to construct a ship that would actually move.
Yeah, I've got you, honey.
They weren't just moving the camera. You could see that there's a ship moving, and that was on the soundstage.
One, two, look out, we're moving.
When they were
taking off for Europe, and Lucy missed the boat ship, and we put her on the ship by helicopter in front of an audience.
A helicopter?
Now, come on, we're almost over the ship. Now, out you go. 1, 2, 3. Are you all right?
Huh?
All set?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Hometown and the comic genius of Lucille Ball.
Of sorts, who actually ran away from home 2 or 3 times. She learned at an early age that laughter was a tonic of sorts. And by the time she was a teenager, her dreams of those bright lights and stardom led her all the way to New York City. Well, Mom may have left Jamestown, but she carried those small town middle class values of her childhood with her forever. My brother Desi had never been to Jamestown, New York before. And I wanted to show him and his family, and you, where Mom grew up.
We need to go to Jamestown. We're trying to go into Jamestown. We're trying to go into Jamestown, New York.
Was born in, Desi. 69 Stewart.
It's nice and cool here.
You take one of those. You know where you are? You know what the name of this street is?
Is this Lucy Lane?
This is Lucy Lane. That's it, Desi. 59 Lucy Lane. Isn't that a cute little house?
Hmm.
That's where Mom grew up, in that house. Here we go.
This is unbelievable. That we're all here. This is great.
Oh.
This is beautiful inside. Look at the nice wood.
I used to put on shows in this room because there was a curtain rod. I swear to you, Desi. There was a curtain rod in the living room, and she used to draw the curtains, and this would be like the auditorium, and Mom and everybody would put on shows because they could come up and down the stairs, make entrances, and look, it's still there.
That's my gosh.
That was the original first stage.
This is where Mom first performed.
This was it. They used to have the whole little band. They used to do these little orchestrations and things.
Let's go see the kitchen now.
Okay. Kitchen. Oh, I'll tell you a funny story. Mom would take too long doing the dishes because she'd be here posing in the mirror, because there was a mirror over
the
dishes.
Instead of doing the dishes.
And it took like hours the dishes wouldn't get done. So finally Dee Dee came and hung a sheet under the mirror. Oh my God. Come here, Desi. This is Mom's room.
Uh-oh.
She had the best
great
view.
Great backyard.
Yeah, Mom had the best view. Lilacs.
So all along here, Lucy?
Lilacs everywhere. These are all big, huge, 100-year-old lilac bushes.
Wow, this is a
look at them all.
Huge backyard.
Lilacs were her favorite flower ever. There, Desi. The one right above that little doorway there, that's Mom's room. The two windows in the middle.
Gosh. It's nice. It's really nice to see this. I'm happy. It's really nice for me to see this with my family and you. This is great. Can I stay here tonight?
You know what she did? I don't know if this came from the stock she grew up with. I don't know how to explain talent.
Back, Mom.
She knew it was funny.
A one, a two, a three, a change. A one, a two, a three, a change. A one, a two, a three, a change. One, a two, a three, a change.
She was just a beautiful, beautiful woman, and I love that she was always dressed and she was always made up, you know, she was always just really well put together.
Say, have you ever met a girl who's the toast of the town? If you will pardon my suggestion, you better write her number down.
She's a doll, isn't she?
Yeah, she had fabulous style.
She was a risk taker in terms of her comedy. I mean, she was doing stuff that was pretty out there, you know.
At the core of Lucy's comedy, to me, was the vulnerability, was the humanity. And that truly made it come to life.
There's nobody like her.
They call me Sally Sweet. I'm the queen of Delancey Street. When I start to dance, everything goes chick, chicky, boom, chick, chicky, boom.
And Lucy does the tango when she had all the eggs in her blouse and winds up doing a tango with the eggs.
The anticipation of knowing that the last part of the dance, she would have to press against Desi with that belly full of eggs. People started laughing before it ever happened.
Have the core of honesty that then makes things funny, and sometimes the most honest things are the most hysterical.
I'm sorry, madam, I can't do that.
Stop this train!
Lady, I can't stop this train once it's started. We have rules, you know.
But my husband isn't on yet. Please, we left him back at the station.
Well, he can take a cab and pick us up at Riverside.
Riverside? Oh, no!
Did you stop this train?
Me?
You.
Well,
Madam, did you stop this train by pulling that handle?
Well, I didn't do it by dragging my foot.
Coming up, how they did it. The magic behind the scenes of I Love Lucy.
I Love Lucy is one of those rare shows where you can get lost in a conversation with a complete stranger. Remember the episode when they did this or that happened? There's a reason for that. Behind the scenes, a whole group of talented people came together every week to structure those stories, write the gag, light the scenes, and capture the laugh with just the right edit.
I gotta get this stuff spliced together. How's it look?
In fact, one writing team wrote nearly all 120-plus episodes during the first four seasons. That is just amazing. In the case of I Love Lucy, the people behind the camera were an extended family to the Ricardos and the Mertzes.
Quiet on a set! This is a take!
The first 40 weeks I Love Lucy was on the air, they did 40 shows. They wrote, produced, and put in the can 40 shows, which is incredible.
Take one!
People say, how could you do a script every week? I always said, Monday morning, Lucille Ball is going to put her hands on the table, and there better be something to pick up.
And there it is, finished. 125 pages, dripping with drama, dripping with intrigue, dripping with excitement.
I better get them up.
Jess Oppenheimer was our head writer and producer.
And Jess taught us that we had to write a script every week. And we said, oh, okay. And he taught us sort of discipline.
Jess would turn off the phone and tell the secretary nothing unless it's an emergency from the set. And we would sit there until we got a story.
But I must, in all honesty, say that every time a script is finished, I'm just delighted. And every time I have to start a new one without an idea for it, I'm in a state of panic.
My dad was always a stickler for logic.
I told you that was too much yeast.
He was a firm believer that you could take an audience as far as you wanted to, as long as each step of the way made sense.
How does the oven door get open?
It began on a Monday morning where they'd all come and sit around the table and they would read.
How do you happen to be the one who is writing this play?
How do you think?
You're the only one that has a typewriter?
The amazing thing that Dad always used to say is,
if you came to a first reading of Lucy, you'd say, keep everybody but the redhead. She's terrible. Fire her.
It's true. She didn't know what she was doing on the first read-through. She'd take the script home, and she'd learn it, and she'd own it. You know, over the course of the week, there were just no heights she couldn't reach. Desi was the exact opposite. Desi would be great at the read-through, and his performance would be exactly the same 4 days later.
Come here.
Best thing and the great thing about Lucy, she would do anything, which made it very nice for writers. Anything you want to think up, she'll do it.
Comedy writers think crooked. When I met my partner, for example, I said, hello. He said, that's what you think. That's crooked. And we would think of the last scene first and then justify our way into that last scene.
Show was the beginning of sitcom. That was the beginning of sitcom. Not only the beginning of a style of comedy on television, but also the method of shooting.
We were starting an entirely new technique of using three cameras in front of an audience and putting it on film, which hadn't been done before.
And Desi would come out every week and give a little talk to the audience about what they were going to see.
Just to show you that the cameras will never get in your line of vision, we make believe that we're taking a scene right now, and I'll sit here in this chair. You just watch and see that at no time your line of vision will be interrupted. You see? Now you see what I mean?
Desi was a remarkable producer, one of the best producers I ever worked for. He learned every facet of the business.
He was the most influential person on the show. He was a leader. He was the boss.
This is a Ricky Ricardo production. Bum, ba, ba, bum, bum, bum.
People often ask us, did you know that you were writing a classic? We say, no. We had a job to do. We were being paid by the week. That's why we did it.
We're all very proud of our work.
Cut! Pretty good. Thanks, sir. That's beautiful.
For that big old freezer of yours? For me.
Well, that sounds like a fair price.
How much?
You'll sell it to us for nothing.
For nothing?
The freezer episode was a topical episode because at the time, home freezers were in all the newspapers about how it pays for itself, it saves you money.
This is wonderful.
Yeah, look how big and roomy. I bet you could hang a whole side of beef in there.
Are you kidding? I bet that you...
Ricardos and the Mertzes meet the biggest stars in Hollywood.
You know, hands down, Lucille Ball was the biggest star on television. But as Lucy Ricardo, she often played second banana to some of the biggest stars in the world, who almost always played themselves. Megastars from Broadway and the movies. People who didn't do TV. So, here you have the real-life queen of comedy falling all over herself when she meets a famous person. Believable? Absolutely. Funny? Oh, yeah. Why? Because it was Lucy, honey. You know, she got her start as a dancer, like a chorus girl. And no matter how hard she worked or how famous she became, she often saw herself as a supporting player. Now, that's funny. So, here's Lucy, shining bright, amongst all those other stars.
Get that girl! I want to make her a star!
I want you to meet John Wayne.
Oh. Well, I'm Rock Hudson.
Mrs. Ricardo, please, take your flippers off me.
Eve Arden.
Freddie Bear has been a naughty boy.
I especially liked the show when famous guest stars would come on. And they used a lot of them.
Miss Bankhead?
Yes?
This is Lucy Ricardo.
Yes?
I don't know if you remember me or not.
I'll never forget you, darling.
Ida Lupino and Howard Duff. We know who we are. Who are you?
It just seems that every time that Lucy gets close to famous people, something happens to them.
Mr. Lamas, please stop this thing. I want to get out.
You're Bob Cummings.
Forgive me for not getting up. I'm very flattered that your wife is such a fan of mine, stealing my footprints. Is she here?
No, no.
Oh, well, that's too bad. I've heard a lot about her from Bill Holden.
Oh, you're just wonderful.
You have to forgive me, Mr. Holden. I kissed Bill Holden.
Ricardo, you mean to say that you've been married to her for 15 years?
Yeah, 15 years.
And they call me Superman.
Come in, Arthur.
They called and said, Lucy would love to have you play this character. I had said, I can't really do it. I've done it on radio for 7 years. I cannot do it in television.
1, 2, 3, 4. Wow! Ooh.
But the opportunity to work again with Lucy was just too good to pass up.
Arthur, what's the matter with you?
I like it.
Lucy Ricardo, where have I heard that name before?
Romeo and Juliet, Jamestown High School.
Orson Welles is a brilliant actor. Just staring at watching Lucy rehearsing.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
And I said to him, what are you watching? And he said with that stentorian voice, he said, I am watching the world's greatest actress.
Now the princess will feel nothing. And definitely speak nothing.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo.
The guest stars were all big stars. And yet, when they came to the stage, they were in awe of Lucy.
Lucy, I am drawn to you like a moth to a flame. I cannot help myself.
Morning, beautiful.
I'm Ernest Ford from Bent Fort, Tennessee.
You'll do.
You got quite a hitch in your get-along.
There's so many memories that just make my childhood alive again.
Are you two dames out of your head?
I waited to see things like when she and Ethel went to steal the piece of Brahmin's Chinese.
I brought you a 6-month supply.
I was laughing out loud in all of those shows.
If I call off the game, I'd be out of a job.
You got a lifetime job looking for that note.
We thank you so much.
Hey, I may never go back to NBC.
Lucy has a girlfriend of hers here from New York, see? And this girl is just dying to meet a big movie star. Yeah.
Big star like you?
Yeah, that's... So listen, Harpo, would you do me a favor and go up to room 315 and pay him a visit? Uh-huh.
Coming up, Desi Arnaz, the gifted performer, and his proud heritage. The I Love Lucy 50th Anniversary Special is sponsored by GLAD. Don't get mad, get GLAD.
Stop gawking. You're acting like a tourist.
I have a feeling we've run into a whole nest of them.
Telephone for Gregory Peck.
There he is.
If you two Johnny jump-ups don't sit down, I'm going to eat by myself.
Telephone for Ava Gardner.
Where?
Order yet, Mr. Holden?
Yeah, Gus, I'd like to start off with that. A Cobb salad.
Yes, sir.
And a cup of coffee.
Yes, sir.
And you know, I sometimes wonder how a person like that would feel if the shoe were on the other foot.
Lucy.
Oh, here she is. Honey, I want you to meet William Holden.
Right, Lucy?
It's very exciting meeting you, Mr. Holden. You're my favorite movie actor.
I grew up in Artemisa, which is a small little village like 45 miles out of Havana. In Cuba, the people, most of the people don't know at all who was Desi, who was Mario Bauza, or even Celia Cruz, or every of the major Cuban artists who live out of Cuba. After I moved, 1990, they took all the records, all the things, all the videos. Nobody's allowed to show anything, any picture, any paper, nothing related to my name at all. Like I die.
Our dad left Cuba when he was 14, and not a day went by that he didn't miss it. Now, in Spanish, homeland is patria. It also means haven, even paradise. Dad always told us how much he wanted to return one day. His feelings, his longing for the blessings of freedom, for his native land, and his gratitude for the wonderful life he found in his new patria, America.
Patria.
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 Where my hopes
Dios te dio.
And dreams were started.
Todo tu encanto.
Patria.
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 Ya no estás.
But now we've parted.
Extraño tanto.
Yes, it seems so far away. Just wishing you could stay with me. I know that someday we can make it the way it was meant to be.
Rosas blancas.
There's a place, though miles apart, it's still here inside my heart. Close my eyes.
Dazzy's family was a very influential family in the province of Cuba that they came from. They were landowners, they were professionals, and his father was the mayor of Santiago. The Cuba that Dazzy Hernandez grew up in is the Cuba before the revolution. However, it's not the revolution that most people think of. This is the revolution of 1933. There was all kinds of civil disturbances all over the country. Places were pillaged, people killed. Their own house was burned down in Santiago, and that's why Dazzy's family had to leave. So he had to go all the way to the depths in order to climb all the way to the heights.
The tragedy of exile is exile. What you really want to be free is at home. But home is no longer free, so you'll always have that sort of hole in your heart.
Dazzy never really left Cuba. He brought Cuba with him to America.
Dazzy probably helped American audiences and Anglo audiences to start getting into those rhythms in a very nice way. He did more for Spanish people than many people here in America may think.
We owe him a lot of fans. As a Latino, as a musician, as an artist, as a Cuban, we're very, very, very proud of him.
We came to this country and we didn't have a cent in our pockets. From cleaning canary cages to this night here in New York, it's a long ways. And I don't think there's any other country in the world that could give you that opportunity. I want to say thank you. Thank you, America. Thank you.
I remember speaking to the late, great Tito Puente, who said that there are two periods in Latino music. There was before Dazzy and after Dazzy.
Your Highness, I understand that your favorite number of ours is Babalu.
Ah, Babalu, Babalu.
One, two, three, four.
Cuban-American from Miami, Florida, born and raised in Miami. Miami is like, I guess as close to Cuba as I can imagine, because I've never seen Cuba. When I recorded the song, I did have old style in my mind. I wanted to keep it like a kind of retro, like an homage, you know, to Tessie Hernandez.
Babalu
is a prayer almost to the Babalu god.
Babalu.
A television landmark, the birth of Little Ricky.
I don't know what's the matter with me. I've been getting a lot of rest and that I wake up feeling all dragged out in the morning. I don't have much energy, and yet I've been putting on a lot of weight. I just feel bleh. Wait a minute. You don't suppose... I don't suppose what?
Lucy was pregnant again. And they thought this was a catastrophe, because you couldn't even say the word pregnant on television at the time, let alone show a pregnant woman.
The whole thought is utterly ridiculous.
And my father said, congratulations, this is wonderful. We'll just have Lucy Ricardo have a baby, too.
Lucy?
Why not incorporate it? This is a couple that is married. She's going to have a baby. Let's have it.
All my life, I've dreamed about how I was going to tell my husband when we were going to have a baby. See, he'll be sitting right here, see? And then I'll come over and I'll sit on his lap and I'll put my arms around his neck and I'll say, Ricky, darling. Ricky, darling. Ricky, darling.
Hey, Rick.
What? Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute, everybody. Now, stand still. Don't make a move. My wife came down here to tell me something very important. That's the only thing that counts right now.
One of the things that my father did to allay the fears was to have a rabbi, a priest, and a minister, sounds like the beginning of a joke, come in and review each script, and they blessed.
Babies are being pregnant or looking pregnant, and Lucy looked pregnant.
I
I'd only ever seen my mother pregnant and some ladies in our neighborhood. I don't think I'd ever seen anybody pregnant on TV.
Here.
This pistachio?
Yeah, that's pistachio.
Now pour that right on top of this.
But honey, these are sardines.
Oh, boy.
And the fact that we had seen her through her pregnancy, gone through all the morning sickness, gone through all the what shall we name the baby, the whole country just stopped and held its breath for that episode. The most famous birth in this country.
Ricky, this is it.
Morning, she did give birth to Desi. And that night at 9 o'clock, we went on the air and Lucy gave birth to a little boy.
Finally, this baby was born and it was as if it was our baby.
It was on the front page of the paper. Lucy gives birth. And that's amazing.
We're having a baby. My baby and me.
That was historic television.
You'll read it in Winchell that we're adding a limb to our family tree. While pushing that carriage, how proud I will be. There's nothing like marriage as your father and mother, and they'll agree.
Coming up, the universal appeal of I Love Lucy.
Ricky?
Johnny?
Do you like earthy women?
What's earthy?
That.
Well, we don't call that earth in Cuba.
Oh, what do you call it?
We have five words for it. Ay, 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 ay.
The hangers you called for, Signorita.
Oh, Carlo. Yes.
Signor Bellboy, would you translate the story for me on Vittorio Filippi?
Ay, 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 ay.
How about that? It's the same thing in Italy.
Scusi, signora. The name of the picture will be Grappolo Pungente.
Grappolo, what does that mean?
It means bitter grapes.
Ha ha ha!
I Love Lucy quickly grew beyond the confines of our little 10-inch black and white television sets to become a global phenomenon. And 50 years later, it's more apparent than ever, as the characters and the situation of cross generations help bridge the boundaries of cultural differences and touch the hearts and the funny bones of us all. We still cherish the idea of Lucy and Ricky and Fred and Ethel as our friends and neighbors and even role models. Some of us even collect memorabilia. And some of us have been inspired by the great talents of those marvelous performers. And all of us just simply look forward to having a bit of them in our lives every day.
There's Chaplin and Marilyn Monroe and James Dean and Lucy.
I can handle all the merchandise you give me.
Lucy, what did you buy?
We've got watches, jackets, bathroom accessories. We've got sheets coming out.
This is an ice cream sandwich made exclusively with I Love Lucy.
It's basically your classic Monopoly game, but everything's customized. So here's Go to Jail, and it's one of the episodes where they're actually in jail.
You can send me a postcard now and then.
We set our clocks by Lucy. It's just such a part of the fabric of everything.
We meet once a year for our Lucille Ball convention.
Are you tired, rundown, listless? Do you poop out at parties?
Are you unpopular?
You be Ricky Risker, no.
So why don't you join the thousands of happy, peppy people
and get a great big bottle of this stuff?
I couldn't be happier. It's a great way to make a living.
I don't think there's anybody alive that wasn't exposed to I Love Lucy.
Ah, Lucy!
Everyone, no matter where it was, if it was Japan, and I think if it's in the Arab world, or in Africa, or in Europe, everyone could relate to the humor and the relationships that were played out every week on I Love Lucy.
Don't have to speak English or French or German or Spanish. They speak to everybody.
There are very few situation comedies or comedies that an entire family can sit down and watch.
Let's see what's on, huh?
Okay.
You can really tell they're in love. I think it comes through somehow.
Lucy, you look so beautiful. Will you marry me?
Yes.
And it might be one of the reasons that people like the show.
Do you love me?
Sure, I love you.
Would you climb the highest mountain for me?
It was always about the love and how, you know, for 22 minutes, this love made us laugh.
I love you.
Lucy, what do you want?
Lucy and Ricky are on TV somewhere every second, in every country and language.
I'm nothing but a big, bloated bunch of blubber. No soy más que un globo inflado a
punto.
The reruns that are coming up today, it is fun to watch, and they're still holding up today totally perfectly, just like they did when it first came out.
Anyone who said we'd be on the air in 2001 and beyond, I would say you're crazy.
It's a moo-moo.
I believe the I Love Lucy show is playing in some far, far galaxy right now. And there are people out there actually understanding us through them. And it's not a bad calling card.
Let's face it, Rick. When it comes to money, there are two kinds of people.
the earners and the spenders, or as they are more popularly known, husbands and wives.
Yeah, brother, if they had to make the dough, they would think twice before spending it that fast.
Yeah.
What's so tough about earning a living?
Yeah.
Have you ever done it?
No, but I could.
Ha!
We'll change places. We'll get jobs and you take care of the house for a week, okay?
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Hey, listen, by the way, what do you know about rice?
Well, I had it thrown at me on one of the darkest days of my life.
No, never mind that. I mean, how much do you think we should use for four people?
Well, I don't know. People like that stuff.
Well, how about 1 pound per person sound?
That sounds about right.
This is your last chance. If one piece of candy gets past you and into the packing room unwrapped, you're fired.
Yes, ma'am.
Let her roll!
Well, this is easier.
Yeah, we can handle this, okay?
Number one I Love Lucy episode of all time.
Those who love Lucy have voted, and they have selected the number one I Love Lucy episode of all time. Drum roll, please.
Okay, Joe, I'm ready to rehearse the commercial. Where's the girl?
She's studying her script. She'll be right in here.
This the new sponsor?
Yeah.
Stuff any good?
Well, it ought to be. It's got everything in it. Meat, vegetables, minerals, vitamins.
Wonder where she is.
Alcohol, 23%.
Are you the young lady that's going to do the commercial?
Yes, sir.
Well, let's run through it once.
All right.
Now you stand right over here.
Yes, sir.
Now, let's try it once, and remember, be bright and vivacious.
Yes, sir. Are you tired, run down, listless? Do you poop out at parties? Yeah. Are you unpopular? The answer to all your problems is in this little bottle.
Now, you pick up the bottle.
Oh.
A little higher. That's right.
Vitamita Vegemin contains vitamins, meat, vegetables, and minerals. Yes, with Vitamita Vegemin, you can spoon your way to health. All you do is take a tablespoonful after every meal.
Now you take some.
Oh. It's so tasty, too.
No, 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 no. Look, you
You're supposed to like the stuff. You've got to smile, be happy.
Yes.
Now try it again.
Yes, sir.
It's so tasty, too. Just like candy.
Nope, once more.
When I was a little boy, or whether it was yesterday, whenever you turn on the television and you're flipping around and you come to an episode, you stop.
Are you all right?
Oh, I feel fine, but you know it's hot in here.
I can never pass up an episode, even to this day. I think I'm going to watch it for a second, and no matter where I've tuned into it, I'll watch the whole one. I've never turned it off.
I Love Lucy celebrated a lot of things. It celebrated a happy marriage. It celebrated a marriage of two different kinds of people. It celebrated the love of children. It celebrated friendship. And best of all, no matter how much trouble everyone got into, it always had a happy ending.
Hard to believe they're all gone.
Hey, look at that.
Gee, that's a cute couple. I wonder whatever happened to them.
Haven't you heard? They live happily ever after.
We have had fun, haven't we, honey?
Yes, sir.
Daisy and Lucy, you have entertained the world, and you have done so much for bringing smiles to people's faces.
You made America laugh. You made America sing. You will never be forgotten.
Thank you. Wherever you are, and we will never forget you.
Happy anniversary, darling.
Happy anniversary, sweetheart.
If Mom and Dad were here tonight, I know exactly what they would say.
Muchas gracias.
And we love you, too.
Good night. Good night.
I love Lucy and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. Sometimes we quarrel, but then how we love making up again. Lucy kisses like no one can. She's my missus and I'm her man. And life is heaven, you see. 'Cause I love Lucy, yes, I love Lucy. And Lucy loves me. Everybody.
I love Lucy and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. We have our quarrels and then...
I'm gonna give you such a punch.
Oh, we love making up again. Lucy kisses like no one can.
She's my missus and I'm her man.